Hi, I'm James Mackey, and here is your bite-sized top tip to give you a short way to the top if you want to rock and roll. In today's top tip, we're going to be covering a topic you may run into when using any oscilloscope for the first time, AC/DC. Nope, not that AC/DC, AC/DC coupling. And remember, if there are any top tips you want to see in a later episode of PicoBYTE, let us know in the comments section. When you get your new oscilloscope, you notice in every channel you see this DC-AC ground switch, and chances are it'll be left at DC for the majority of the measurements because it just works. But that can get you feeling a little thunderstruck. When DC coupling, it will show you the signal, and it will also show you if you have a DC offset. This is perfect for measuring a power supply, as you can see the current voltage it's producing. Where AC coupling comes into its own is when you want to look at the ripple of the power supply sitting at the top of the 12 volt offset. This can be tricky with most scopes, as when you start to zoom into the ripple, you can see there is barely any definition in the amplitude to get a reading. One of the ways we can get a better reading is by switching the channel to AC coupling, filtering out the DC component with a high pass filter, showing you just the alternating section of the waveform. That will make just a ripple appear around the 0 volt mark. We can now reduce the voltage span, increasing the resolution of the smaller signal. Then, huzzah, we have our measurable voltage ripple using an AC coupling setting. Not only is this useful for analyzing ripple and power supplies, but also useful for measuring things like AC waveform inputs in an amplifier like you can see in this example here. You will need to remember, as AC coupling is a high pass filter, along with removing the DC component, it will also attenuate some of the lower frequencies, potentially skewing square waveforms, making your results less accurate. As a rule of thumb, be sure to only use AC coupling when you explicitly need to look at higher frequency DC offset signals. For anything else, stick with the DC coupling to keep your waveforms as accurate as possible. Another solution to viewing offset AC waveforms is to get a scope with a higher resolution. Pico offers a range of 12 to 16 bit scopes, such as the 4000 series or the 5000 series FlexRes scopes. These will give you enough resolution to be able to see a decent amount of power supply ripple, even when DC coupling is chosen, dependent on your voltage scale. It gives you the advantage of being able to measure ripple on top of already alternating waveforms, such as this. But we'll go through higher resolution scopes more in a later episode of PicoBYTE. So that should get you off the highway to hell when it comes to choosing AC or DC coupling. I've added a full length article in the description below for more detailed information about coupling and your scope's resolution, so be sure to check that out. Click the videos here or here to watch more episodes of PicoBYTE, and remember to like, comment and subscribe, and ring that little notification bell to make sure you get all the latest PicoBYTE videos. And we'll see you next time.